electric cars more reliable than internal combustion engine vehicles? It's a question lots of people have been asking me for years, and it's a topic that electric vehicle fans bring up pretty consistently to highlight why driving a plug-in car is less hassle in the long term than owning an ICE vehicle. On paper, it makes complete sense to say yes. After all, internal combustion engine vehicles have far more moving parts than an electric car. And that's before you even take into consideration the complex cooling and exhaust systems that most modern internal combustion engine cars have that plug-in cars simply don't need. So when US consumer research organization Consumer Reports published its latest auto reliability survey last week, a hefty tome providing reliability ratings and feedback on more than 300 different vehicle models made between the year 2000 and the year 2017, electric vehicles managed to feature a fair bit in the soundbite media coverage thanks to their more reliable nature. For example, the Chevrolet Bolt EV, a car that's only been on sale just under a year, came out as Chevrolet's most reliable model out of the 15-strong vehicle lineup, earning itself a very reliable rating and providing support to the notion that electric vehicles are more reliable than internal combustion-engined vehicles. Perhaps more interestingly, the Chevy Bolt EV managed that in its first year of existence, which is something which bucks the industry norm that new model cars, especially ones built on brand new platforms with brand new technology, tend to experience a few years of average or below average reliability before any initial teething problems are hit on the head. The reason I can think in Chevy's case, though, that it's done so well has perhaps less to do with the fact that a Bolt EV is an electric car and more in the way that GM built the Bolt EV. Rather than follow its traditional automotive development process, it's a pretty lengthy thing that's mainly in-house, GM collaborated heavily with its battery provider LG Chem on the Bolt EV. Indeed, engineers from LG Chem worked alongside GM's engineering teams to develop not just the vehicle's 60 kilowatt hour battery pack, but also its entire high voltage system, including motor and drivetrain, as well as developing in-car telematics and electronic systems. As one of the largest suppliers of electric vehicle battery packs and an established electronics manufacturer, LG's influence in the design of the Bolt EV no doubt helped GM nail reliability from day one. So what of Tesla? Well, since it only makes electric vehicles, it's difficult to compare the luxury Model S and Model X to an internal combustion engine vehicle. But despite languishing in 21st place as a brand in the lineup of reliable automakers, the brand overall did better than it did in previous years, thanks to the Model S earning its first ever above average rating. The Model X, meanwhile, with its more complex vehicle body systems and less time on the market, suffered badly in the survey, scoring below average, which is something I'm sure kept Tesla down near the bottom of the reliability table. Despite this, however, the Model S's above average rating and the way that Tesla has worked to improve Model S reliability over the past 5 years has led Consumer Reports to predict that Model 3 will likely score average reliability in its first year. Something that, as I've already intimated in this show, is almost impossible for a new vehicle. But that's upset Tesla, which has hit back at Consumer Reports for its prediction, and unfortunately, it's reignited a feud Tesla has had with Consumer Reports' rating system, despite the Model S being the highest rated car in the history on Consumer Reports' website. And in case you're confused here, the reliability survey results are only part of the process that Consumer Reports uses to produce overall vehicle ratings, explaining why the Tesla Model S is not at the top of the reliability ratings yet, but it is at the top of the vehicle ratings table. I unfortunately don't have time to examine Tesla's claims or CR's rebuttal here, but I'll link you to the relevant pages in the description below. So far then, we've got one very reliable rating, one above average rating, and one below average, with a prediction that Model 3 will produce average reliability at launch. And while I can't go through all of the car brands in the survey or all of the models, Consumer Reports has confirmed that so far, most electric vehicles are far more reliable than their internal combustion engine counterparts for any given brand due to their far less complex drivetrains and onboard systems. Indeed, Jack Fisher, director of auto testing at Consumer Reports, said that the Tesla Model 3 should be the least complicated Tesla yet, justifying the organization's predicted rating for the affordable sedan. The only plug-in to fare less well than its internal combustion engine counterparts, the BMW i3, which actually came at the bottom of BMW's vehicles in terms of reliability. I should note, however, that as a brand, BMW was the fifth most reliable brand in the survey, so I guess everything is subjective. The conclusion? Electric vehicles are more reliable than their internal combustion engine counterparts. But with the occasional exception, it's usually best to wait a year or two before buying a plug-in car that's about to hit the market, just as it gives the automaker time to iron out any problems before you buy yours, the same as it would be for an internal combustion engine vehicle. Do you agree with the Consumer Reports verdict? Do you have one of the cars I've mentioned today? And are they as reliable as the report suggests? Let me know below. That's it. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Hit the notification bell to hear the moment a new show is uploaded, and click the Patreon link at the end of this video or in the description below if you want to help me make more of these videos. Until next time, keep evolving.